The state of Kuwait will undertake a major repatriation effort for its nationals stranded overseas beginning April 19th after cabinet officials earlier approved protocols on how to bring them back home.
And under the directives of His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, the Kuwaiti government set out a five-phase plan to bring back all Kuwaiti citizens by the holy month of Ramadan. More in the following report by Nadia Ali.
Under the directives set by His Highness the Emir Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, the Kuwaiti government is set to bring back citizens by the holy month of Ramadan. The cabinet, at an extraordinary session last night, adopted a phased process to bring back citizens abroad who have remained there amid the ongoing COVID-19 crisis. Deputy Prime Minister, Minister of Interior, and Minister of State for Cabinet Affairs Anas Al-Saleh, in a statement after the special meeting, said the ministers during the session followed up on efforts for combating COVID-19 and adopted the plan to bring back home Kuwaiti citizens from all corners of the world. The session kick-started with the Minister of Health and head of a team tasked with following up on the COVID-19 developments, Sheikh Dr. Basil Al-Sabah, briefing the ministers about the latest information about the pandemic, including data and statistics included in reports of the World Health Organization. The ministers were also briefed by Foreign Minister Sheikh Dr. Ahmed Nasser Mohammed Al-Sabah, who, along with the Minister of Health, presented details about the planned operation. The plan's execution of which was scheduled to begin on April the 19th, envisioned five phases. The first phase would be due on April the 19th to the 20th, covering Kuwaitis who completed medical treatment abroad, along with their companions, also tourists or those who were on official assignments. The second stage is set to commence on April the 23rd, and that covers patients who need medical beds and life support equipment. The third one is set to begin from April the 25th to May the 1st, is for students. The fourth, from May the 3rd to the 4th, is for diplomats, and the fifth, to start on May the 6th to the 7th, is for other segments. Later in the session, Minister of Oil, Electricity and Water, Khalid Al-Fadl, briefed the ministers about the recent agreement by OPEC and non-OPEC oil-producing states to slash crude production by less than 10 million barrels per day. The ministers lauded the deal that would stabilize the markets and back the global economy in the current extraordinary circumstances. Moreover, the cabinet lauded the designation of Mustafa Al-Kadhimi to form a new government in Iraq, hoping the move would lead to attaining the people's aspirations.